Hey guys, and welcome to Car Guy 1999 Reviews, as well as Quirk Auto Dealers. As you can see, today we have the 2016 Chevrolet Corvette Z51, the Stingray Z51. Oh, this one is fitted with the 7-speed manual transmission. Part of our pre-owned inventory, this one has little over 9,000 miles and is in probably the best shape I've ever seen one of these cars. Absolutely beautiful quad tip exhaust, multi-mode, so you have quiet mode, loud mode. Oh, it's just absolutely spectacular. Finish here in torch red. Goodness, this car is beautiful. The amount of heads it turns just driving to get here. Nice Corvette kick plate. Nice and easy to get in and out. All your books and manuals. Do have a nice hatch area, so it's actually really practical. This one is fitted with the glass roof, and it is absolutely beautiful. Frameless rearview mirror, of course. Just look at that. 7-speed manual, nice, really, really short throws. You also have the performance data recorder. Just really, really cool. You can also raise and lower the screen to reveal a nice little hidden cubby hole. Heads up display, let me actually increase the brightness so I can have a hope of seeing that in the video. Nice seating position. Actually is kind of roomy in here. Once you're in, it's nice, comfortable, definitely driver focused. Here's your keys. Put those right there. Bunch of different drive modes. For this drive, we're gonna put it in track. I also have enabled rev match downshifting via the paddles on the back of the steering wheel. I'm gonna get a few comments anyway that are gonna be like, why are there paddles? So that turns on and off the rev match downshifts for the manual transmission. So instead of doing it yourself, the car perfectly matches the revs for you. During the drive, I might try to do it myself just out of curiosity and see what it's like. There we go. So what about the driving experience? With the C7 Corvette, Chevrolet blew it out of the ballpark, and it was just absolutely mind-blowing and a huge improvement upon the C6 generation, which wasn't actually that bad. I've driven a fair share of C6 Corvettes, Z06 and ZR1, and they were phenomenal cars. Interior was a bit lackluster. I've always had a soft spot for the interior of the C6. I'm not sure if it's because I grew up. You know, I was like 10 years old when that car came out. Actually, no. I was 10 years old when they, 13 when they ended production of it. You know, so that gives you, I was 10 years old in its heyday, pretty much. I was 5 when the C6 came out, actually, now that I think about it. But the C7 was really, for the first time, a world-class sports car. Handling was phenomenal. And the C6, or the C7 Z06, 650 horsepower. The ZR1 has over 750. That is just astronomical to get for right about $100,000. To get that world-class performance and everything just in an American homemade supercar. Not homemade, but you know what I'm saying. And the C7 blew it out of the ballpark. You know, especially this car is almost 5 years old now, and it still looks good. And that still, to this day, believe it or not, the first car I ever reviewed for my channel was a 2015 Corvette C7 manual. So it's kind of cool. That car was a non-Z51. This car is a Z51. So it's kind of cool to see a pleasing circularity to it, you know, and come back after, I think, that was back in 2016. So it's been 4 years since I've driven that car, and I still feel right at home. The performance blows me away. This car is listed for $49,999. And I still think that's an absolute bargain. I think the C7 Corvette is gonna go up in value. Might not be right away. And it all depends on if they bring the manual to the C8. It's always going to be the last front engine Corvette. As they said, Chevrolet engineers, when I was at the C8 media launch, they told me they have reached the limit of what is possible with the front engine Corvette. There's no more to be had. I mean, when you're pushing 755 horsepower, you're running into a lot of issues with grip in the back, and it's not gonna be solved by putting more power in it. Whereas the C8, starting on a whole new platform, whole new design that harks back to Zora's vision back in the 1960s, there is a future to be had there. There is huge performance benefits to putting the engine out back, but that doesn't mean this car is bad. Good God! And you can just put it right into 7th, and she cruises 65 miles an hour at 1300 RPM. Like, come on. That was probably the last full throttle acceleration, because at the end of the day, we're on a public road. I don't want to lose my license. Such a fantastic car. And honestly, a bargain in today's market. And it's only going up from here. With that being said, I want to thank you so much for watching this video. Please like, share, subscribe. And I'll see you all in the next one.